Have you ever looked up into the night sky and wondered? Wondered what possibly could be out there? Are there other forms of life? How far away is that star from Earth? Am I looking at a star or a planet right now? And if so, which one? Welcome to Astronomical Thoughts from a Fellow Earthling, the podcast that is all astronomy talk and just astronomy talk. I'm your host, Maddie Kermy, Medfield TV's assistant production coordinator, and in this first episode, we're going to be talking about outer space as a whole and how big, in fact, our planet really is in the grand scheme of the universe. So in my opinion, outer space is the most underrated topic to talk about among us humans in Earth. Because when you think about it and put it into perspective, outer space is the one thing that really brings everyone together and unites us all. No matter where you are from in this world, no matter what you look like, no matter what your interests are, or even your age, despite all of that, everyone can talk about the same outer space as there is only one. Every living thing on this planet, from it being humans to insects, animals, and even plants, all eat food that was grown under the same sun. All life on this planet is alive because of the same sun. And people get sunburn and see light because of the same sun. And everyone looks up at night at the same moon, and we all live on the same planet. And despite us humans relating to this topic so greatly, a large percentage of the human population is not very familiar with our solar system and outer space in general as a whole. Now let's talk about our planet, our home, Earth. We're on a 4.5 billion year old spaceship, and we are orbiting a power source that is over a million times larger than our ship. In our group, there are over 200 billion more power sources with ships just like ours. Now I want you to pick a location in your life. That location is moving at 2 million miles per hour next to an object, the power source, that is over 150 million light years away. You are on a planet that is orbiting a star at 30 kilometers per second, and that star is orbiting the center of a galaxy at 350 kilometers per second. That galaxy is moving through the universe at a rate of 600 kilometers per second. Now in the past 30 seconds, you have traveled around 3,000 kilometers. Yes, life is definitely more exciting than you think of it. And yes, Earth definitely does complete many marathons daily. And in reference to the light year, one light year is 9.5 trillion kilometers. One light year is 37,200 human years. Now I'm hoping that you think that that is a very large number, but to convince you even more, Mars, the planet next to us, aka our neighbor, is 4.35 light minutes away. And it takes over 6 months to get to Mars from Earth in a spaceship. Which means that 4.35 light minutes takes over 6 months to get from Earth to Mars. Stars in the night sky are generations and generations away from us. Now Polaris, the North Star, is roughly about 323 light years away from Earth. Polaris has 6 times the mass of the Sun, but because it's so far away from Earth, it is a peanut from our point of view compared with our Sun. Do you feel small yet? Now either we are all alone in our 93 billion light year universe, or there are other forms of life out there. But both of these possibilities are equally terrifying. Since our universe is so large, light from stars takes so long to reach us that we are actually looking back in time when we look up at the night sky at night. Outer space is over 99% empty space. 99% empty space. Just think about that. 99%. That means that not even 1% of outer space is made up of celestial bodies. In 2 days, in 4 months, in 22 years, it's not going to matter if you ate that extra cookie or hung out with that friend that night or studied an extra hour for a test, because in the grand scheme of the universe, that means nothing. Now, the average lifespan of a human is around 79 years, and there is an invisible clock ticking away in the background, which means that it will take generations and generations to get familiar with what us humans relate to the most, outer space. Thank you so much for listening to Astronomical Thoughts from a Fellow Earthling. Stay tuned for the next episode. See ya!